Hello, everyone. This solution is going to be for Chapter 5 skill building, T2C. It's also going to indirectly flow into 2D as well because they're very similar. I'm going to try to make this a little quick because there's not really a whole lot going on here. Something that's going to throw everyone off right away, well, a majority of people who are having trouble with this problem, this dotted line, you know, most people look at it and say, well, that just must be to separate the angles. That dotted line is actually the direction that the mass is moving. They don't make that real clear in the problem, and it actually took me a little bit to kind of figure out, okay, oh, that is, you know, what it's moving. So if we know that that is the direction it is moving, we know one thing right away. Well, you know, one thing we definitely know right away is that this component force and this component force have to be equal. We know that these two have to equal each other because it's not moving in the y direction, only in the x direction. So what does that tell us? Well, since we know our variables given to us are F1, theta 1, and FR, we know that this, what is this? Well, okay, it's F1 sine theta 1, right? That's how much we know, which means this has to be the same thing. Now, remember, we're finding tan, right? So tan, you know what, SOHCAHTOA, you know, when you do that little analysis here, tan is just going to be opposite over adjacent. Well, what's the opposite of this angle? Oh, the opposite is, you know, oh, hey, this, F1 sine 1. So we'll go down here, and let's make our correct color in a little reddish here. F1 sine theta 1. Boom, we have our top. So now we have to find out, okay, well, what about this? It's not going to be this whole big purple thing, Joe. I know that whole big purple thing is 28. And from part A, which, you know, I'm assuming you probably already did if you're jumping on this bandwagon already, we know FR is going to be F1 cosine theta 1 plus F1 cosine, oh, F2, sorry, cosine theta 2. So what is F2 cosine 2? Well, that's what we're trying to figure out. That is the adjacent. And so if I had, you know, F1 sine 1 over F2 cosine 0 theta 2, I'd have the right answer. But I don't have that. How do I get that? Well, let's break this down, make it real easy here. I'm just going to erase this, right? Another name we can call this, we can just call this the variable adjacent. Because that's what it is, right? Well, now I just got to solve for it. I mean, basic algebra here. So, you know, now I know that the adjacent is equal to f of r. I mean, I'm just moving stuff around here. F of r minus f of 1. Cosine theta 1. Oh, well, hey, now I have the adjacent. I'm just going to plug this sucker up here. Let me go back to my pretty little red. So now I know f of r minus f of 1 cosine theta 1. Boom, that's your answer. That is going to give you tan theta. Now, in part D, the very next problem, it's going to ask you to solve for it. All you have to do is plug in these numbers. You know what F1 is, you know what theta 1 is, you know what FR is. All you have to do is plug in those variables and then arctan this, you know, or, you know, whatever you want to do. You could do it. Now, if you do it on your calculator or off the computer, make sure you're in degrees and not radians. You know, versus if you're on the computer, then you could just do the long thing of typing this all out. I prefer the other way, but all you gotta do is put in this arctan. Don't do anything fancy with this now. This is gonna give you the degrees. This is going to give you angle 2. And then once you have angle 2, you'll be able to solve part E fairly easy. So that is how we are gonna come up with this formula. A lot of people have been asking me questions, so I did just want to clarify on that, make sure everyone was on the same page.